real, it's not fake one.
No, it is real.
Okay, there Mandy sir is the co-host and we are already live. And there Shivani is also the co-host. Yes, all yours, Shivani, go for it.
Thank you, Lakshmi. Thank you. So namaskar, good evening, and welcome back to another fantastic session of Inspiring Indian Women. Well, it's been a long time since I've seen all of you, so really nice to be on this platform again. Thank you, Lakshmi, for letting me do this session. The guest today is, he needs no introduction on this platform. He has graced the platform with his presence on various occasions. He has shared his wisdom, his experience, his knowledge on several topics with us. And today he is again going to talk about the topic that he has discussed before with us. And we're just continuing on to the previous sessions of happiness and prosperity. So calling today is Dr. Mandeep Singh, popularly known as Mandy Sir. Mandy Sir, thank you for gracing us once again with your presence.
Thank you so much, Shivani, and thank you, Rashmi, for once again inviting me. And I'm sure you will continue to invite me thereafter as well. That's Absolutely. What I hope for.
Absolutely. Well, you have, for every topic, you have so many sessions, we have to invite you because we need to know what happens next.
Yeah, but for this topic, I think I'm going to conclude today.
Okay, fantastic. So happiness and prosperity it is. We've done the first session and the second session. Today is the third session, right?
Yes. Khushi or khushhali.
How about we do a quick recap of what was done in the first and the second session, and then we start with today's session.
Sure. So I will just tell you that khushi, this happiness, is a state of mind. It doesn't depend upon anything or any person or any circumstance. And the best way to be happy is to make someone happy. And that's what the secret is, which perhaps we need to know and spread and let it not be a secret. That is the message for khushi. And khushhali also goes along with when you feel that you have enough to share with others. And so you feel nourished and you feel like nourishing others. That's again a state of mind. And how can we achieve that state where we are khush and we want to feel that khushhali within? That is, we are happy and we want to feel that prosperity within us. So how it comes? So the quick take on that was that we think that we have this kind of notion, which is a wrong notion, of course, that once I will gain some, I will gather some kind of material, I will gather some kind of resources, I will be happy, and then I will have enough, and then I can share it with others later. So that moment will never come when we feel that by simply possessing more and more material and having more and more resources in tangible form, that we will be happy. That's a clear-cut misgiving, and that what needs to be dispelled. So in the last two sessions, we had established to some extent that more important than the physical facilities, like you have money, like you have assets, like you have property, like you have stock and so on and so forth, some bank balance and so on. So instead of having these physical facilities or the resources to buy these physical facilities, more important than that is the relationship. And when I say relationship, it means relationship between you and the people around, the humans around. That's what we call, when I say relationship in this session, this is what is meant by relationship. And even more important, and the most important of even these two, is the right understanding. We understand human beings well, we understand ourselves well, only then we can develop a good relationship with other human beings. Until or unless, see, if I want to have a good relationship with you, then I need to understand what exactly you want, what exactly you need to derive from that kind of relationship. It cannot be just one-way process. So for that, I have to understand you. And to understand you, I have to understand myself, because primarily you are no different from me. You know, all human beings have some basic, you can call it, structure is not the right word, it looks more like material. So basic form, or it's a basic, you can say, makeup of mind. We call that mind thing, not as a mind, but we call it as self. So you have a body and then you have a self, and the complex of this body and self is what human being is. So when you call it as self, it's primarily mind only, but then to mind you can add soul and spirit, and don't want to get into the nitty-gritties of mind, that whether it's an active mind or conscious mind or subconscious mind or unconscious mind. So all those things, we don't want to confuse you with all those psychological terms, and therefore we call it as self, that this is self. So we have body, which is very much tangible, which feels the pain and pleasure in the form of senses. And then we have self, which is something beyond this, something much more than that. And that's what we discussed, what body needs. Body needs nourishment, body needs rest, body needs comfort. But then there is a limit to it. We go beyond body and we go to the concept of self. So this is what we had learned, or tried to learn myself. I'm learning on these sessions once again in the previous two sessions. And from that point onwards, that there we took a micro break. It was supposed to be a micro, but it happened to be for 1 month somehow. Anyway, we will move on and perhaps try to finish off this topic on khushi and khushali. Although, you know, we keep on learning. We are lifelong learners. We are all lifelong learners, and we learn more through our own experiences, especially the bitter ones. So we should leave the bitterness behind and carry on the lesson forward. That's a way to be happy once again. So this is the quick recap of what we did in last two sessions. And then we had a micro break. We will continue from that point onwards.
Brilliant. Okay, fantastic. So are you going to share the presentation with us?
Yes. I'm going to share the presentation and you will give me the feedback whether it's visible or not. I'm going in full screen. And this is the last but one slide on this. I think it's all visible.
Absolutely. It is visible.
Right. So this was where we left. These are the last two slides. Just to maintain the continuity, that what do you understand? How human beings they are like while selecting and eating food. For example, I'm selecting something for my evening snacks or for the dinner or whatsoever. So four options were given in the last session, that you want the body to be nourished and you want the self to be happy, or you simply want body to be nourished, self may not be happy, it may remain unhappy. Or sometimes the body is not nourished and the self is happy, and the body is not nourished and the self is also not happy. So Shivani, your take, honestly, what kind of food would you like to have? It's very
what
obvious
I would
though.
Like to have, or what I should have?
both indeed. So when I say be honest, it means both what you should have and what you normally have.
Normally, I'm a simple girl with food. So I would like to have normal ghar ka khana, as long as I can have my dal, roti, rice, sabzi, yogurt, I'm very happy. But even that sometimes becomes a lot, considering all the carbs involved in it.
Okay. So when I say this, that body is nourished, so someone gives you exactly what you want. Ghar ka khana, dal, roti, whatsoever you said, salad, dahi, bhat, achar, whatsoever you said, exactly, right? But you know, instead of saying some sweet words like, okay, Shivani, mere bache kha le, bahut acha lagega tere ko, I know you are tired all through and I feel that main tere ko haathon se khila du, koi mama jaisi ya papa jaise, so you will feel good. Or someone simply, you know, comes and puts the plate in front of you and say, le kha. Then how will you feel? Same food.
Very, very bad.
Same food.
Yeah.
Right?
Very, very bad, I would feel.
Very bad. So this,
with food and drinks, I find it very, very offensive when someone doesn't serve you properly. And with a smile, considering I come from hospitality background.
Yes. So what they say, that especially in case of food, you don't eat food with your you don't taste food only with your tongue. I mean, you have to feel the ambience. You have to see that the music, soft music, is also nourishing you, giving you the pleasure. The temperature is appropriate. The neatness, the cleanness, the fragrance, everything, yeah, everything, everything matters, right? And the way you serve with a smile, everything matters. So you just don't eat or taste your food with the tongue or mouth. Eat with your mouth. So every all five senses, and then the texture of the food should be good, and all those napkins and everything, you know, much better than in this case. So there are things. Someone is forcing you to eat when you're not hungry, right? Or you're eating junk food, or you select a nutritious food and the tasty food, but again, the way it is served, that also matters. So it's not just the body that needs nourishment. It's not that your tongue that needs to be, somehow it should be stimulated to give you some taste. But then there is something other than that, you know, the etiquettes, the mannerism with which it's served. So that appeals yourself. So this is what the meaning of body and the self is brought out very clearly in this example. So now that you know the difference, it was a recap to know the difference, very taking little baby steps, we move, taking very simple examples, not going in for too mind-boggling terms. When do you tend to make more mistakes? When your self is disturbed within, or when your self is comfortable with? Most of the questions are very, very obvious. But anyway, your take.
Disturbed, definitely.
Obviously, right? So when yourself is disturbed, then you're likely to make so many mistakes. Even the road rage which happens, and the extents that happen, and you're lost in your thoughts, and someone has said something nasty, and it's just echoing in your mind again and again and again, and you tend to spill something in the kitchen, or you tend to write something in the mail and then send it, and then oh, that's what I've done, or That happens. You make mistakes when your self is disturbed within. So how to make yourself comfortable? This is something what we all spiritual seekers have been trying to do over so many centuries. Attain Buddhahood, attain that level of calmness and peace, and going in for a beatific smile all the time. Ekdam mast. So that's what we are going to understand the human being, and how that is going to make the difference in living. So that's what we are. We had stopped last time, and Shivani, you keep on reading the chat as well, because if I start reading chat, okay.
In fact, I do want to say Counselor Pushpa Makwanaji has got some good insight to share. She just said that one has to let go to make more space for happiness and create positive memories. That's so true. But letting go is so difficult. And I think if everyone learns to let go, half the population would be saint. It's not easy.
Yes. It's difficult to let go. But then there are some techniques where you cannot take the thing out from some vessel. You put something else and the vessel overflows and it gets diluted. So it's method of replacement. That's what we do in case of most of the physical and chemical processes. Same is the case with mind, that when my mind is too much locked down with some nasty things which have happened, and those things keep on haunting my memory. And then the good way is that you replace them by something. And if nothing else, then that's where we say the chanting of Bhagwan ka naam, that helps a lot. But that's not right now what we are discussing. Of course, we can discuss this thing as well. But first of all, let me first finish off with this topic. And all these things are related, interrelated. As such, as I normally say, someone said, mera gala dukhta hai. I said, what do you mean by mera gala dukhta hai? You are not a subset of collection of so many organs. Gala alag hai, kuch alag hai. It's only that your gala ke aage symptom aa gaya hai. The problem doesn't lie in your gala, in your throat. It's somewhere in the entire system that gets manifested. So we are all connected within the body. All organs are connected and all systems are connected, and so on and so forth. So we should not treat our systems as parts. It's called reductionist view. On the other hand, there's another view which is called the holistic view. In health, we take holistic view, that is taking the complete body as one being and not digestive system separately and circulatory system separately. And similarly, extending this thing, we should take the entire existence and the entire cosmos as in a holistic manner, not in the reductionist manner that, okay, I'm a male, you are female, and then I'm an Indian, you are British, I'm Gora, you are Kala, that kind of thing. And then I am human being and you are an animal, and then we are living beings and this is just a resource. This is a plant kingdom, or this is a resource like Ganga, and so on and so forth. Everything is integrated. So body, soul, mind, spirit, everything, entire existence is taken as oneness. And that actually is the secret of happiness. When we are going to develop this kind of view, then to make someone happy, you will definitely get happiness, because you don't see anything other than yourself in everyone. So that's a kind of vision. But then it becomes too spiritual right now, where I see my extended self in everyone. So, you know, as we say, sarbadda bhala, that let everyone, well-being of all is not an option for me. It is the way to make myself well, that I seek wellness of all. So we move further from this point onwards, because otherwise Mehndi's gyan bahut gehra ho jayega. So we have already seen that when myself is disturbed within, I tend to make more mistakes as compared to when I'm comfortable within myself. Now, we all know, we all need to be respected. If someone simply throws even much more delicious and nutritious food in front of us, as we do not even treat our dogs these days. In the stray dogs, sometimes we throw the food to the stray dogs, primarily out of fear. We don't want to go near them, and we say, chalo le kha. So that kind of thing should not happen to us or to any human beings, or even to our own pets. They also feel offended many a times. So do you think that a small child also needs respect, or only when we grow we have to respect the elders?
Oh, definitely a small child
definitely needs, you know. Is it only a rich man, or even you think that a super also needs to be respected?
You know, I think everyone. I've always respect for individual.
Yes.
That's
yes.
Something you need to learn all the time.
Yes. So this is something we all have to be very, very careful, that every person needs to be respected.
Yeah.
Right. So when we say respect is to be given in all cases, or it should be conditional, depending upon whether the English is fluent or not. In all the cases. You're absolutely right. In all the cases. So what is the outcome? The outcome is that, of course, all human beings are same. They look different, but their requirement is same. They need to be respected. They feel good when you respect them, irrespective of their color, creed, caste, economic status, age, etc., gender, and so on and so forth. So this is to sum up that, as you have already said, that human being as such is a coexistence of self and the body. Body needs physical facilities, and those physical facilities can be fulfilled by the physiochemical things. And these physiochemical things, they come from rest of the nature. We have petroleum, and we can have so many things coming from the petroleum. And then we have wood and fiber and cotton, from which we can get, let's say, different types of clothings. And then we have minerals and metals and so on and so forth, and fuel. We can have cars and so on and so forth. We have silicon, refined silicon. We can have electronics. That happens to be my branch of engineering as well. So that's what we teach in most of the cases. I have been teaching these kind of subjects for last 33 years. It's only in the last few years I've started talking on the subjects which are related to self. Ever since I guided a PhD on spirituality some 5 years back. But before that, and even now today, what I'm getting paid for primarily in my universities for teaching the physical facilities only, like how to make good things, a good transistor, and then the good TV and the good computer and so on, and good embedded systems, you call it. I don't want to go into what are embedded systems and so on and so forth. All those mobiles and wearable devices. So these are all physical facilities, and that's what most of the universities and most of the education systems, they are teaching in technical and non-technical things. We are mostly working to make money so that we can buy more and more physical facilities for ourselves and for the people who are dependent on us and the people we love. But then happiness is the need of self. It is the right understanding. It's the right understanding and the right feeling in the self. It's to be fulfilled as such, which cannot be fulfilled by a physical facility. This is what we see, that it cannot be obtained. If you think that simply by giving a physical facility to someone, you can get his or her love, you are mistaken. You are grossly, we are all, and I say you, we are all grossly mistaken, because that alone is not sufficient. I'm using the word alone. That alone is not sufficient. You give someone flowers, but then you have to say something sweet, you have to emote, you have to write, you have to, you know, somehow make him or her feel in a manner that this is something very special for you and a care, and that's why I'm giving you flowers. Simply flowers will not make the things as such. So I will not go in for all that kind of assignments you normally do with the rest of the students and the people, where you actually go in for collecting the data from how you, what do you feel like and how you have done this and how you plan to do, what plan to do on this. That part I'm going to skip for the time being, and we come to the concluding part of the session as such, which is trust. What we call it as trust is basically the foundation of a relationship, as we say, because everything boils down to relationship, and we have to have proper understanding of the relationship. More important than the relationship is the understanding of relationship. And in this case, we are going to have this magic word, trust. That is what we are going to, because that is that's where the whole understanding revolves around. So going for the trust part, we will say that when we say it's a relationship, as you can see, when it's two people, I1 and I2, let's say me and you, for example, then a relationship is already there. Whether we recognize it or not, the relationship is already there, because we two are here. Let's say we are sitting in front of each other, talking, gazing. The relationship, we use the body to express the relationship, right? So there are feelings in relationship, in one self for other self. So if I say that I have a relationship, now, you know, these days word relationship is used only for the physical kind of relationship. But then even mother and son, that's a relationship. Friend and friend is a relationship. So that way, you can say I and Shivani and Rashmi, we are all have relationship. It's a kind of what's we say, that there are some feelings, and these feelings are definite. This is some, there shouldn't be ambiguity about the relationship feelings behind the relationship. So again, you know, can we talk about these feelings with definiteness? What are these feelings with definiteness? Or you feel that sometimes they are abstract, they cannot be discussed, and so on and so forth. So this is, you can have a discussion, but right now I'm just coming to the conclusion without any discussion that these feelings are quite definite. So whenever we say that, when I say relationship, I don't need to mention that it's a bitter relationship. I want to say the kind of relationship it should be, ideally. So what is naturally acceptable to us? I want to be in relationship with you. Should there be a feeling of trust or mistrust? Should there be feeling of respect or disrespect? Should there be feeling of affection or jealousy? Should there be feeling of gratitude or ingratitude? Should there be feeling of love or hatred? I think we are very definite about what is naturally accepted. What is naturally acceptable to us is the first part, trust and not mistrust, respect and not disrespect, right? There's no question mark about it. There's no ambiguity about it. They're very, very definite that this is what is naturally acceptable to us. This is what I would like, or everyone without exception would like to have or like to be in relationship with X, Y, or Z, or Z as they call it. There should be feeling of trust, respect, affection, gratitude, and love, and not that of mistrust, disrespect, jealousy, ingratitude, or hatred. It's very, very natural.
Yeah.
Now it then means that's not
that a relationship. If yes, you have the partner, it's not a relationship then.
Yes, it is not the relationship we would like to be in.
Yeah.
Right. If at all that relationship has boiled down to that sorry state, we would not like to remain in that kind of relationship.
Yeah.
Right. So that becomes something very toxic. Sometimes we feel like moving out of that relationship. Sometimes we are able to, sometimes we are not. Right. Because say this kind of relationship happens and the relationship, it deteriorates. This is a relationship between me and my mother, for example. Say for example. And I cannot walk out of from that relationship, obviously, right? I should not. I have duties, being her son, for example. But then somehow, kat rahi hai zindagi, aisa karke bolte na, chal raha hai, kat raha hai, because something has gone wrong and our relationship has gone sour, as we say, right? It's not, or sore, as you call it. It's not sour, sore, right? So that's what we see. It has happened to our relationship. So why has it happened? Because, you know, it's because of lack of understanding. And this lack of understanding is what we're going to discuss today, right?
Before we move on, let me just quickly say, because she's made a very valid point, Counselor Pushpa Ji. She said, nothing should be labeled. We have to go with the flow. We need to learn to apologize and move on if we have done anything wrong, which stands true. Again, I would say, but it's very difficult to do at times.
Yes. And why it is difficult? Because again, we are missing on something in the understanding. We're missing on something in the understanding. And that's what we're going to see. Why? Yeah. And we try to say that there are complaints in our relationship due to absence of one or more of these feelings which have been listed above. And if we try to compensate it with some physical facility, will it work?
No.
If we try to, because, you know, you bring chocolates or you bring flowers or you
only bring momentarily
it will work, you know, bring some expensive gift for you, yeah, but then uske baad phir dobara kahani wahi dhaak ke teen paat, as we call it in Hindi,
right?
Char paat ya teen paat ya char paat, whatever, right? So we go in for that. So
it doesn't even work for 24 hours. I say it with experience.
yes, sometimes it doesn't work at all. You see, upar upar se kar raha hai,
exactly.
And you become all the more suspicious, and that's all very pretentious, and there's no genuineness in whatsoever he or she is doing.
Yeah.
Now, one thing is that we all want to get respect, and we know that everyone wants to get respect, right? So, what should we do to get respect? Very simple. We should start giving respect. As simple as that. This is what I always say. Mm-hmm. That when we talk of rights, right is a matter to be given. It's not to be taken. So let us give rights to all. Right? And everyone will have rights. So people will understand that, okay, we have to give right. Right? So that's the way out. But that requires a great deal of patience and understanding. And that's what we say, that everyone is begging for respect and everyone's bowl is empty because no one is giving respect and everyone is expecting respect. So if we start giving respect, so without any, you know, conditions attached to it, that, okay, I have given you respect. Now you give me back your part of respect, which is due to me. That's an expectation. And if it doesn't happen, then I will take my also respect given to you back. That kind of thing should not be there. So that's what we are going to talk about, the feelings, the right kind of feeling, for which trust is the foundation. So it's a foundational value as such, that we want to be very, very assured that this person is the one who wants to make me happy and prosperous. If I say, Shivani, I trust you, it means that you will be doing all what you can to make me happy and prosperous within your means, within your limitation, within your all abilities and the skills and competency which you have, right? Which may be lacking. You may be lacking in some of the resources and competency and skills and so on and so forth. But your intention is to make me happy.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I do not doubt your intention. You may not be having that kind of resource. You may not be having that kind of skill. You may not be having that kind of competency. But I am quite assured of the fact that you want me to be happy. You want me to be prosperous. And that's what trust is, right? So this is my definition of trust. When I say I trust you, it means you fall in this category.
That's right.
Right. So we will now see this. This is perhaps the axis around which the whole thing is going to revolve. So this is what we will study very, very carefully. But before that, if anyone has any comment, you please see it in the chat and let me know if there is anything we need to discuss before this point.
I just have one comment from Counselor Pushpaji. She said, we make it difficult. We need to work it out slowly. So, you know, trust relationships. Sometimes we make it difficult on our own and slowly we need to just work it out. I agree.
Yes. Dil hai ki manta nahi.
Manta
isko, nahi. Isko samjhana padega. It will take some time. So this is what we come to. You know, this slide is perhaps the most important of all the slides which we have discussed so far in last three sessions. This is the third session, as you know. So when we say about our natural acceptance, I want to make myself always happy. Yes or no? Or there is any doubt about it?
No, I want to be happy all the time.
Right. I want to make the other in relationship always happy. Yes or no? Or you have any doubts about it?
No, absolutely. Yes. Everyone surrounded by me should be happy with my
should
presence.
Be happy.
Yeah.
The other wants to make himself or herself always happy. Yes. Or you have any doubts about it?
No. Yes.
Yes. And the other, whosoever, maybe your employer, maybe your neighbor, maybe your the person who you have hired for some work and so on and so forth. The other wants to make me always happy. Always. You have some doubts on this or you are always very sure that the other...
They should make me
they
always...
Should. It's not should, but they really want. Do you think they want?
It's subjective, right?
It's subjective. So you have question mark.
Yeah.
That's why, Shivani, I always say that you are my best host. Right? Because we click well. That's what's the meaning of clicking well is that you think the way I want it to happen. Right? So this is the point where we pause and think.
Yeah.
Right? It's the intention, right? Yeah. That I'm quite sure about 1, 2, 3, but then there's a question mark on point number 4, right? Honestly speaking.
Yeah.
Now, we come to about our abilities. That I want myself to be happy. But am I able to make myself happy? And that also always?
Not all the time.
Not all the time. There can be reasons for that, but I'm not all the time.
Yeah.
I'm able to make other happies all the time.
Of course. If I'm not happy all the time, I really can't make others happy all the time.
The others also want to make themselves happy all the time. And are they able to?
No.
Dunya itni achhi hoti kahan phir, hai na?
Itna easy
hota. There's a question mark there also. And last point, if you see on the 4A, corresponding that would be 4B, that the other is able to make me happy all the time? Able to?
No.
Of course not. Uski to hume intention pe hi doubt hai na? Uski to hume intention pe hi doubt hai. So this is the main difference between what is naturally accepted to me and what is what we think about ability of others and ourselves in terms of everything on the left hand side, 1A, 2A, 3A, 4A. If you want me to turn my laser on, I can tell it with this 1A and 2A and 3A and 4A. It all comes in the set or subset of intention. Whereas able to, I'm able to, he's able to, she's able to, that comes in the category of competence, right? So what happens is that whenever I am not able to make myself or others happy, right? I don't doubt my intentions. I always say that my intention is to make myself happy. My intention is to make others happy, but I'm not able to make myself or other happy. It's because, not because of my lack of intention, but because of my competence, right? But when it comes to others, we often think, rightly or wrongly, is something I don't want to discuss at this moment of time. But when it comes to others, we always feel that the others also want them to make themselves happy. They have intention to make themselves happy. And if they're not able to make them, it's because of their competence. But here is the main point. When it comes to me, you know, instead of doubting their competence, we start to doubt their intentions. So that is, I think, it sums up all the things. This is the crux of entire thing. We can elaborate, we can go forward, we can talk of this thing for hours and hours and days and maybe weeks and years. For the lifetime on this one point, right? This is the crux, that whenever I'm not able to do anything, it's not that my intention was wrong, but there was some lack of competence within me, skill, resource, competence. But when someone else is not able to come to my mark, we don't give any benefit of doubt. We start judging. We start doubting the intentions, and then we start, you know, forming a pattern. Pehle bhi nahi kiya tha, usse pehle bhi nahi kiya tha, and last birthday also he forgot, and he never remembers my birthday. Is something wrong because he never thinks good about me? And not that, okay, the guy has poor memory or is stressed out, but has intentions to remember my birthday and greet me and make me happy. So we don't, you know, doubt his competence, but we start doubting his intention. If somehow we accept this thing that the way I am having all good intentions to do all good things for others, for the people around me, as you rightly said, that I want to make everyone around me happy, whether it's a janitor or sweeper or director or whosoever, right? Driver or whosoever, right? Neighbor or friend or colleague or my business partner, whosoever. My intention is to make them all comfortable and happy, happy and prosperous. Similarly, I have to convince myself, jo ki bahut mushkil hai, dil hai ki manta nahi, nahi manega, that others too have intention to make me happy and prosperous. If at all they are not able to make me happy and prosperous, it is not that their intention is bad, but only they don't have that kind of competence. They may not be having that kind of communication skills, for example, right? So they may not be having that kind of grooming, that kind of etiquettes or that kind of sensitivity in them their intention is good, but then they say something nasty because of all these things, and that makes me feel bad. And then instead of focusing on their competence, their lack, feeling little bit sympathetic or making an effort to improve their competency, we start thinking other way around. We start doubting their intentions, and that strains our relationship. Do you think, Shivani?
Mandy sir, isn't it true if someone is, whether they are successful or not, if the other person has the intention, the efforts will show whether the efforts are successful or not. But if the efforts are genuine, then it'll still make you happy. You know, happiness is you want to be around that person still, you know, no matter how successful the person is. So I think that if, regardless of the intention, if the intention is true and they're making an effort, then result doesn't matter.
So do you harbor some ill will for someone and fake the things and bear some kind of ill intentions towards other people?
No, right, I
accept the answer. No, right. So why should the others also do the same to you?
Yeah.
No, see, it's reflection. The whole world is your reflection. The world is not as it is. You don't see the world as it is. I will come to you, just 1 minute. The world is not as you see. The world is as you are. I'm going to give you mantra today, Rashmi, to you also, and to anyone which has worked for me n number of times, including yesterday. Right? Yes, please go ahead.
Rashmi?
Yes. Can I say something?
Sure.
Sorry to interrupt, but when Shivani said that, I have no ill will for anyone else, and the other person also should not, Mandy sir, you said that if you don't have ill will for anybody, others will also not have, and it's a reflection. But I always face something else. I don't have ill will for anyone, but people have ill will for me. The reflection doesn't come, you know. I want to move on. I want to go ahead. I don't want to look back. I want to move on with life, but it just keeps on coming behind me. What do you have to say for that? But then you please continue with your session. We can talk about this later.
No, not later. This is the right moment, and this is very right question, and it's so relevant. Right. So it's not question of talking later. This is very rightly brought up. You rightly brought up this point here at this moment of time. I'm glad you did. Now tell me, Rashmi, since you have asked the question, can you talk to an empty space? And how long, if at all? You have nothing in front of you, not even a tree, you know, nothing, no wall.
Mm-hmm.
It's an empty space. For 1 mile, you can't see anything. For how long you can talk to that empty space?
Yeah, I agree to that. We can't. Yeah.
Right. So that's it. So, okay. You know, when you talk to someone, you are evoking the response. That response can be positive, negative, anything. Right? So if there's a child in front of you and you slap him, child, I know, you know, it's not allowed in civilized countries like Britain, but it happens quite often in India. Right? So you slap him. What do you expect? You expect the child to cry. You expect the child to say, no, mama, or nahi, I will do whatever you want, and so on. You want the child to be scared, right? And if the child sits there stone-faced, marlo ji, karlo ji, theek hai na, kehte bachcha dheet ho gaya, aisa bolte hai na Hindi mein, dheet ho gaya, right? So you don't want that kind of, you don't expect that kind of behavior from a child, ki marlo ji, theek hai na? डीट हो गया ये तो कहोगे नहीं ये तो गड़बड़ कर दी मैंने मार के इसको तो कोई फायदा ही नहीं है मारने का ये तो कुछ इज नॉट गिविंग मी एनी रिस्पांस टू दैट राइट नाउ इट मींस दैट सपोज you become like that. To all the people you feel are your opponents, right? So they will also feel ki it's futile, you know, I'm spending energy unnecessarily, bol raha hun, kya kar raha hun. Then again, there's a thing, there's a catch in it. There's a catch in it. It's very important to know this catch. And this is what really matters in relationships. One thing is you become like a mirror and reflect. Tu pagal, tera baap pagal, teri khandan pagal. You're reflecting and reflecting also with a lot of amplification. Right? That's what we normally do. Reflect. Second thing is you absorb. Someone has said something bad to you and you don't reflect, you don't rebound. But then you feel hurt and then you keep it within you. It becomes your resentment. You develop that stress. You are absorbing it, right? And killing yourself within. You're keeping, you're holding that toxicity within you, right? So the third thing is you become transparent to it. Then ek kaan se suni, dusre kaan se nikal di. You're transparent to it. When you become transparent to it, and the other person also, after, you know, day, 2 day, third attempt, seventh attempt, nth attempt, will come to know that this person is transparent. It's not even keeping any grudge against me. Not even holding any grudge against me. What to say of, you know, reflecting back. It's transparent. Wo bolenge, iske saath to koi farak padta nahi hai. Why should I spend my time, you know, writing bad things or saying bad things or, you know, spreading bad rumors about this kind of person, right? And what will happen? Jo banda aapke liye, the person who's spreading all those bad things about you, he talks to third, fourth, fifth person, and they know you also, right? That this person is so transparent, right? तो क्या तू ही पागल होगी जो बार बार उसके बारे में बोलती है वो तो कभी रिस्पॉन्ड ही नहीं करती इस चीज को शी सच अ साइलेंट स्वीट लेडी राइट शी सो ट्रांसपेरेंट लाइक शी नाइदर रिबाउंड्स गिव्स रिबटल नॉट शी होल्ड्स एनी ग्रज नॉट शी इज डूइंग एनी काइंड ऑफ निंदा टू यू तो तू ही सारा टाइम उसके बारे में पक 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 करती रहती है तू ही खराब होगी राइट बट रश्मि सो ट्रांसपेरेंट राइट सो Do you think it's not going to work?
I agree to you.
Right? And after some time, 3 days, 3 years, 30 years, वो person कम से कम आपकी निंदा करनी छोड़ देगा. सोचेगा नहीं किसी और को target करते हैं जहां से थोड़ा मजा आए थोड़ा reflect करते हैं ना जो तीखी मिर्ची होती है उसको खा के मजा आता है ना जो तीखी मिर्ची होती है आंख में से आंसू निकलते हैं ठीक है ना एक ब्लैंड सी मिर्ची ले लो उसको कौन खाएगा उसमें कुछ है ही नहीं है तो. Right, because it's not she or he is not getting the response he or she was expecting or trying to evoke by saying something nasty or writing something nasty or doing something nasty to you.
Right. But I would also say, Mandy sir, going with your presentation and what we've discussed today, if certain person is doing such a nasty stuff to you, then clearly it's not a relationship. Then you are not in a relationship with that person. They are not others for you. You know, they're not in your space. And somebody outside of your space, they can do whatever. And like
and you want to bring him or her back to your space?
Well,
no.
If you...
No, yes. Answer is yes. You want to.
Hey, where's Zoom? You probably know us for our meetings.
What
happened? Here's a few things you might not know.
But you want him or her to be in your mind space and you want to be, you want to be in his or her mind space because there are some relationships you don't want to walk out or should not walk out. Sasuru ka rishta, for example.
Correct. So some, the right. ones want to be in, then obviously you work on it. Like, you know, counselor Pushpaji said, you work on them, but some relationships you just don't want at all because they are toxic. Like,
so how to remove the toxicity of the toxic relationships? This is what you
like
want.
You just said, be transparent to them.
And this is one thing. And you want them transparent is one thing. You want to make all their efforts futile.
Right.
But then you want to introduce a little bit of sweetness also in the relationship. Right. That's the second part. I'm coming to that. But then there is some hand raised from some person. Let's listen to him or her.
Sometimes I feel there are certain people.
No. There is a hand raise among the participants.
Yes, Kokiji. Kokiji, would you like to unmute yourself? Do you have a question? No, maybe it's my mistake.
No.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes. We can. Please go.
Obviously, today's topic is very, very interesting. There are certain relationships that we all have. And although they are toxic, they are the sort of people like relatives, for example, who you cannot get rid of. So you have to have a continuous relationship with them. And when you feel you are the person giving in all the time, trying all the time, and you do not get any response back, what do you do?
Yeah,
exactly. Not only you're not getting the response back, the kind of response you're getting is rather bitter. Right. Yeah. So that's what the question is about. Can we... about Nana than Bhavi. You understand Hindi? Nana than Bhavi? Little bit.
Okay. Sorry, English is a better.
So, of course. So it's between sister-in-laws, like husband's sister, your husband's sister.
Yeah, the problem I have is my husband passed away recently. And it makes things very, very difficult. You try your best. You absolutely try your best. And there is absolutely no response. The worst thing of all of it is that they don't even give time to the children, to my children. And although my children will do, you know, they are young adults, they will do, if I convince them to go to them, to go and see them, I will go with them. They will do everything that the mom asks because I'm the only parent left. What do you do when you have no response at all from them? The grandmother, you know, doesn't even, knowing that, you know, her son is gone, will not even... doesn't even have the courtesy, I don't know what you would call it, to even hug your children. It's, you know, before when I had my husband, we would both talk about it. And at least, you know, he would relay or he would say to me, don't worry about them or whatever. The problem I have now is how do I keep this relationship going? For the sake of them being part of, you know, my husband's family, if they don't want to give in anything.
Right, I get it. So I'm going to give you one mantra for that. You try it for, let us say, 2 weeks, 3 weeks.
Yeah.
And then you let me know whether there is some 1%, 2% change of mind or not. Right. So one thing is, first of all, you forgive them. This is the first thing. Very, 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 very difficult. You forgive them for their conduct. You forgive them for all they have done or all they have not done, which they were supposed to do. So this is called act of omittance or act of committance. So either way, you have to forgive them and forgive them from your heart. Again, assuming or presuming that they don't have any ill intention towards you. Assume it. Just fake it for the time being. Assume it. And the second thing, which I often say, which has worked for me a number of times, including yesterday. I want to bring some sweetness between me and some person X, right? So let me call that X as some arbitrary name, Aarti, for example, an Indian name, Aarti. right?
Yeah.
So the mantra is, the mantra is that very difficult. You know, you can chant this mantra sincerely only when you have forgiven Aarti for all what she has done, right? Mantra number one, it has three parts. The first part of the mantra says, I love Aarti. Right? It is relatively easy to say. It's relatively easy to say, I love Aarti.
Yeah.
The second part of the mantra is very difficult, that you say, Aarti loves me. Right? This you will say, how can I say Aarti loves me when she doesn't love me?
Yeah.
Right? But then you have to forgive her for all she has done or all she has not done, which she should have done.
Yeah.
Right? This is the second part of the mantra. Right? This is, and the third part is even more difficult, that all Aarti has done for my well-being, and all that Aarti will be doing will be for my well-being. It's very, very difficult to chant this mantra, taking that person's name when you have that kind of relationship with him or her. Right? So I repeat, it's very powerful.
Could you repeat the third one?
Whatsoever Aarti has done is for my well-being.
Yeah.
Whatsoever Aarti will be doing, right, will also be for my well-being. Right?
Yeah.
Now you will say, no, I cannot do it. Right? And what the difference is going to be even if I chant this mantra? Right? It's not to be chanted mechanically. It's to be chanted from your heart, they'll say. Right? From your heart.
Yeah.
You know, how it works, I tell you, how it works. I know there is a limitation on time today. It works that every one of us is like a radio transmitter and like a radio receiver. Everyone, right? You, me, Rashmi, Shivani, all, right? But some people, their reception is not very clear. For some people, the reception is very clear. But people do receive the messages which we send from our radio transmitter, from our mind. Are you getting me or not?
Yeah,
so,
telepathy is
for two people who are, like, I can say I have telepathic relationship with Rashmi. I'll tell you why. Exactly 2 days back, I thought, hey, Rashmi has forgotten me. I don't know what has happened to my last session, and I should remind her. And why she's not scheduling my session, that happened day before yesterday. And yesterday I got a message that, okay, we have this session. So it means what? It means that I have been able to send my thought to Rashmi, and that has happened, and it worked within 24 hours.
Right.
Right. And I'm not faking it. I'm not telling a lie. You know, you have to believe me. Right. So it's that relationship, I'm just telling that relationship between me and Rashmi are very cordial, warm, full of love and care and affection and all that, right? That's why I just thought for a second, it was a split second thought, and she catched it, right? She caught it and she invited me, right? Now, for the people who are not exactly tuned to you, right?
Yeah.
It may take hours, it may take days, it may take weeks, it may take months, right? But then you keep on trying, they will catch. And some point, they will realize that, nahin bhai, Koki is a nice lady, you know, why are we behaving, what's her fault, and if at all, what's the fault of the kids? Why should we deprive them of all what is due to them? And after all, these kind of things, they will start thinking automatically. They will not even get to know that you are sending them this message. I'm repeating. Number one, I love Aarti. Number two, Aarti loves me. Number three, whatsoever Aarti has done for my well-being. Number four, part 3B. Whatsoever Aarti will be doing or shall be doing will be for my well-being.
Yeah. Can I just ask you a question?
Sure.
You know, this mantra that you're talking about, which is in three parts or whatever, it's a mantra, so how many times are you supposed to be reciting it?
No, it's not number of times.
Yeah.
Right? It's not that you have to recite it 108 times a day.
Yeah.
Every now and then you think about them.
Okay.
Every now and then you have a thought about that lady or gentleman or whosoever, right?
Yeah.
Immediately, you know, you attach this mantra to that.
Okay.
Because any thought which is going from your mind to her mind, it should be followed by this mantra, right?
Yeah.
So it's going to remove the toxicity between you and her or him.
The thing is, you know, when you have tried so much, you give in to everything, you think you're trying to do the right thing and you get no response, then, you know, you come to a point when you think, what is the point? I might be able to do that, but
carry on, but
you know, say when it comes to my two young adults, my two children, you know, young adults, I cannot, especially with the thinking that people, you know, the youngsters have, they say to me, Mom, why do you keep on trying? Why do you just keep on trying? If they're not bothered, what is the point? Because you know, with the worry, with the constant thought, you make yourself ill.
Yes, so I totally agree. Stop talking about them, start writing anything or trying to contact, but just throw this message with every thought you get for them.
Right, okay.
When you've done so much, you can do this as well, right?
Yeah.
This is something very powerful. This is what we have tried on many of the people known to me.
Yeah.
And this is what I have tried with myself also. And I said, it has worked. It has always worked. And sometimes it takes more time. And sometimes it's just like, you know, you can cure some disease by a simple pill, but sometimes it needs surgery. So that's what the case is in this type of healing. It's a healing. We are healing the relationship.
Right.
The relationship is not broken, but it is damaged. It's a bit more damaged in some cases, but it can be healed, always healed. This is what we call it as a holistic approach, that I am no different from anyone on this planet, right? And so I have to maintain this relationship simply by giving a kind of thought that I have forgiven them and appended by this form. Which I've just shared it with you.
Right. Would you, you know, when you said, say, for example, you're thinking of a person by the name of Aarti, which was the example that you were giving, what happens if it's a whole family? Do you just, rather than thinking of Aarti, you know, whenever this is going through your mind, these mantras, can you do it on a family basis?
So how do you get the thoughts? Do you get the thoughts for the whole family, or you get it in terms of one person followed by another, and the last one?
I think I get it, I mean obviously it varies depending on what, you know, what your mind is thinking about, because mine is very difficult with your mind because it's working all the time. You get up in the middle of the night and your mind, you know, is at it, if you see what I mean. So at times it would be a group of people, which is...
So if it is for the group of people, then you give some name to that group of people. The family of Malhotras, for example.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
So I love the family of Malhotras. The family of Malhotras love me. Whatsoever family of Malhotras have done so far is for my well-being, and whatsoever the family of Malhotras is will be doing will be for my well-being. So you can make it as a group, give a name to that group, and chant this mantra every time. If you get a thought in the form of a group, in the form of a family, then you chant the mantra in name of that group. If it is by A followed by B followed by C followed by D, then you also chant this mantra again in this same fashion.
Okay. Shivani ji, I didn't really want to, you know, I just had those questions. I didn't want to hog it up. But the one thing I would like to ask is, this is the first time I have logged in, first or second time. You know, the previous sections, are they recorded and available?
They should be on the Facebook page, right, Rashmi?
Yeah, they are all on YouTube as well. Yes.
Are
the links are there. Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Koki ji, for asking that question. I do have to say, Mandy sir, I just heard the resolution you have offered. And I feel that whether it mends the relationship or not, but it will certainly bring peace in Koki ji's mind with all the positive thoughts.
Exactly.
So I think it's about you getting some peace. And once you are in peace with everyone else, then automatically the relationship will mend in your mind. And it will probably start to show as well.
Yeah.
Exactly. So, Rashmi, what's your take on that?
Yeah, maaf karte jao, but maine kiya bhi hai maaf. Lekin baatein khatam nahi hoti, to main mujhe lagta hai ki main aapka I will accept what you said. Speak to the glass, speak to the wall, and keep on saying that, you know, all forgiven, all done. I'm not going to react, response, evoke answer, and just move on, because otherwise the negativity will not let us move on and grow. So it's better to not respond in that way. I agree to you that forgiveness is the best way to move on.
And should I share another secret with you?
Yeah.
If you will not do this, then what will happen? The same person is going to follow you in your next life and torment you in the same manner.
Oh God.
That's only if you believe life after death.
Yes, right. So then you will maybe next lifetime you will not have Mandy sir around to tell you all those things. So better learn now.
Yeah.
Okay. I take it. Gaat baat.
I think because of this reason, I also take it. Next life.
Right.
Mandy sir, once again, it was so lovely to listen to you and to have all this discussion on this platform. I think these are the kind of talks that are very difficult to do with anyone and everyone, because I don't think that everyone has that kind of sensitivity or knowledge perhaps, or wisdom to talk about it. And it's just so lovely that we have a platform where we can talk about such intense topics. You know, it's as simple as happiness, but as intense as it can get, because it's so difficult to be happy. So thank you for organizing this session. Thank you, Mandy sir, for doing it always for us and gracing the platform with your presence all the time. It's so lovely to have you on board at Inspiring Indian Women. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. And we will remain in touch, I suppose, at least in this lifetime.
Of course. Of course. Mandy, sir, was this your last slide?
Oh, no, I have a number of other slides, but then these are just, you know, follow-up of whatsoever we have said, that all these things, they are elaboration of. But the main thing, it's just what it was there in that slide, that I should not doubt others. Intention, I may doubt others' competence. And if at all it's another's competence, then the reason, you know, why I get angry is not because I feel some lack of competence, but only because of their intention. You know, I don't feel angry about the person who I know is lacking in that resource. So this is just elaboration of all these things, which in the last slide you say is just the way I have intention and I want to have competence to make everyone happy. Similarly, I believe or I should believe that others also have this kind of intention. And if at all they are not been able to make myself happy, me happy, it's because of their competence. So that's exactly, I should nurture my feelings. In that case, I will not be feeling irritated or angry. At the time, at the best, I will feel that, okay, let me enable others to have that kind of competence so that we can have a good relationship. That's all as such. Fabulous. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you. You know, I do want to add something. Mandy sir gave an example between the connection between Mandy sir and Rashmi. And I swear I'm not lying, Rashmi. I swear to God, I had exact same thought for past week. And I was thinking, what happened to Rashmi? Has she forgotten me? She's not sending any host messages. And, you know, I was changing my phone. So I thought, let me change my phone successfully. Then I will text Rashmi. And there you go. In the middle of the phone, I got your message.
You know, now understand that even you started the thought, which triggered a thought in me that why I'm not getting a call, and that triggered a thought in Rashmi. So, you know, we're all connected. It all started with you. Now we
and
have
you know, just I actually thought, are they upset with me? Because I couldn't do the second session. Why are they not calling me?
No.
You were doubting her intention, you know?
No. Everyone, thank you so much for yearning to come on IIW, you know. For us, Mandy sir, you are part of family, and we really like to listen to you because it's all so normal. I want to suggest that you should write a book on all your thoughts, pen it down, and launch it on IIW, because it'll be a great hit, believe me, because whatever you say, everybody needs it, because it's so normal. Today's people, today's students, today's world, these things people just don't know. We don't know how to overcome lot of negative feelings, but yours is the best way to go forward, and you connect with us. So thank you so much once again, and I hope next time coming very soon you will be there again with some other topic, maybe anger management, or maybe things which engulf the youth of today's generation, and not only today's generation, in us also, in me, in the generation of the 90s, you know, I belong to the 90s. So we need you very much to keep on uplifting our moods. Thank you, Shivani. Don't forget, you're again back on Inspiring Indian Women for on the topic restaurant business, how lucrative it is. We have got two women entrepreneurs on having restaurants and in London and Indian cuisine. And let's hear from them. Why are Shivani, how successful they are, and how COVID affected their business. So this is from IIWE outlet, which is going to be launched soon on the 15th of August. So all of you, those who have not registered, we are putting all our forces into aggressive marketing of IIWE outlet, only for women entrepreneurs to share and sell their products. Now, tomorrow we have, very quickly, Aisha Samim, Mandy sir knows her. Aisha will be back tomorrow on a topic called the new normal, COVID aftermath. Is it the way life would be? A lot of things, you know, and we have a patient who suffered long COVID and survived. And she's also a Toastmaster, female Toastmaster, Sonal Dave. And she's going to talk about how she could get out of COVID. And we have a doctor, a psychiatrist, who's going to
uplift you from, you know, how to get back to the new normal and adjust to the new situation, the depression, the psychological aspect of having lost somebody to COVID and how to move on with life. So tomorrow that is there, the new normal with Aisha Samim and a psychiatrist. I forgot his name. His name is, I think, some Mr. Pandey. And Sonal Dave will be there, the Toastmaster. Thank you so much again, everybody. Thank you for from Inspiring Indian Women. This is Manjulika, Shivani, Manju, Koki, all signing off. Take care. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye-bye. Goodbye.
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 Thanks, Manju.
Goodbye.
Good night.